Man, we finally getting a groove, you know. We really didn't have a lot of time during training camp, so we got to just pick it up on the way. And one thing we're going to rely on is our defense. So
it didn't take long into 2021 for the biggest trade of the NBA season to happen. The Brooklyn Nets added another superstar to their duo of Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving through acquiring James Harden from the Rockets. And the trade in total ended up featuring three teams and saw significant talent moving around. But did the Nets or Harden win from this deal? In this video, we'll take a look into that. But first, a simple reminder on how to enter our brand new giveaway. We are giving away either an iPhone X Max, the new iPad Mini, or a MacBook Pro. It's all your choice. So be sure to leave a like, comment the keyword, subscribe, and turn on notifications to enter this giveaway. It's really that simple. The Houston Rockets. The key team in this trade was, of course, the Houston Rockets. After all, James Harden was under contract with the Rockets, and they had the final decision on whether or not he would be traded. It's been said that Harden forced his way out of Houston, and while that's true to an extent, the Rockets still could have held on to Harden against his will if they weren't any offers that appealed to them. But we didn't see that option happen because it likely wouldn't have ended well for the Rockets. Harden was the main player in Houston, after all. He'd been in that position ever since the Rockets gave him a big deal after his move from the Thunder. And Houston showed through their decisions that they had faith in Harden as a leader. At least they did until the trade finally happened, when even their best efforts couldn't make things work with Harden. It wasn't because of a lack of trying for the Rockets. And in a way, even though they were able to get a good amount in return for Harden, they're still the loser in this trade because it means the direction they tried so hard to go in over the past couple of seasons had completely failed. The team first tried pairing up Harden with his former Thunder teammate, Russell Westbrook. And while the two were excited to play with each other again initially, things didn't turn out as expected on paper. Westbrook didn't perform to his full potential with the Rockets, and his statistical decrease and career-worst playoff numbers say something about how bad the situation in Houston was when the Rockets were trying to make things work with both players. After all, Westbrook is one of the most prolific scoring point guards and overall triple-double players in NBA history. We saw in Oklahoma City that he doesn't need the best team situation around him to show up with big numbers and carry the team in multiple categories. On paper, Westbrook should have been able to do better thanks to having quality teammates around him and playing with another superstar in the same starting lineup. But when the Rockets made the decision to bring in Westbrook, things didn't pan out chemistry-wise. It's not that Westbrook and Harden weren't friends, because they did come into this with a good relationship from their days together in Oklahoma City. However, that relationship wasn't enough to make it work when they were in the same locker room once again as the two main players on the team, with no Kevin Durant around this time. Westbrook and various others on the Rockets wanted more out of Harden as a leader. Harden had a reputation for lateness, and other players had a problem with his tendency to try to do things on his own schedule, giving the impression he wasn't taking things seriously. At least, he wasn't taking them as seriously as he should have while acting as the leader of a team that was supposed to contend for titles. The frayed relationship between the two culminated in a situation where it would either be Harden or Westbrook. The Rockets having both just wouldn't work, because Harden was unhappy having someone around that would criticize his game and his practices off the court. We all know that Westbrook is one of the most competitive players in the league, after all. He's not just going to not say anything about what's going on in the locker room because it might step on some toes. And it was reported that Harden didn't respond as well to his criticisms of the team as some of the others. In the end, the Rockets ended up trading Westbrook and exchanging him for John Wall with the Washington Wizards. Again, on paper, this one should have worked out. Some of the reports that came out around the time of the trade say that Harden preferred to have Wall as a point guard instead of Westbrook, and the Rockets could keep their key player around if they could make Harden happy with the current roster. But like the last move, it didn't work out. That's because even Wall, someone who had never played with Harden before in his career and hadn't spent long with the Rockets at that point, could notice something wasn't right with the team direction. He and DeMarcus Cousins went as far as trying to confront Harden about his problems and encourage a change, just like the other things in this bad chain of events for the Rockets. However, that also didn't work. Harden remained unsettled, this time with John Wall acting as the pestering figure inside the locker room instead of Westbrook. Once again, the Rockets had come up with a plan, but chemistry problems were causing it to fall apart before it could truly be set into motion. Harden also wasn't happy about the changes in the organization. The general manager and the coach that he had played under before and won an MVP title with during his best season, and one of the closest seasons the Rockets came to breaking through, were gone by now. The organization wanted a different direction, a direction Harden didn't like. The unhappiness continued, and the James Harden saga became a story around the league. The Rockets eventually dealt him to the Nets to play for his old head coach, Mike D'Antonio, and they ended up with a lot in return. They picked up Caris LeVert, a promising scorer who was the best prospect off the Nets before better talent pushed down his minutes. 3 first-round picks that might develop into valuable players, and 4 first-round pick swaps from the Nets. They got Dante Exum and a first-round pick from the Cavs. They still have John Wall from the Westbrook trade. But their other plan still failed. The Rockets tried building around Harden and Westbrook, and then around Harden and Wall, and neither plan worked out. Both Westbrook and Harden aren't even on the team now, leaving the Rockets with just Wall and some promising talents that aren't star caliber yet, as well as draft picks that might pan out, but might not. This trade firmly puts them in a rebuilding position, and their losing record right now shows the state of the team as far as their playoff and title hopes go. But sometimes you have to rip the bandage off before things will get better, and that's what the Rockets did by finally moving on from the Harden era after various attempts at putting together a winning team didn't work. Brooklyn Nets. The Brooklyn Nets make up the other side of the trade, and there's an obvious upside for them in this move. The Nets are acquiring, of course, the third piece in their lineup of superstars. They've shown they have an interest in winning now, with their acquisitions of Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant. But adding James Harden on top of that pushes them even higher up the Eastern Conference power rankings, and the added depth will likely help them if they run into a team like Miami or Boston in the playoffs. The Eastern Conference is set to be more competitive this year than it has been in some past seasons. Boston and Philadelphia are both strong rivals for the top seeding in the East, and the Heat are coming off a finals appearance that few analysts expected at the beginning of the playoffs. All of those franchises have a good amount of homegrown exciting talent, and have made moves over the past couple of years to add to that with smaller additions that will hopefully push them over the top to win a title. The Nets have the opposite strategy, relying mainly on their big-name free agents. That was their intention when they gave up 2 players, including the productive scorer Caris LeVert, and 3 first-round draft picks to the Rockets to seal the Harden deal. We've seen super teams win titles in the past, of course. Shaq and Kobe, LeBron and the Heat, and Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, Kevin Durant, and Draymond Green have been some of the most notable combinations over the years. But there's no guarantee a combination of star players will reach those heights, and even if they do, there's no guarantee it will last. Kevin Durant's time with the Warriors ultimately didn't last long, and other star pairings just didn't get off the ground. The Rockets with Harden and Westbrook are an example of that. Let's say the Nets don't care about longevity, and they just want to win a ring as soon as possible, so their franchise can join the ranks of the elite. Would that make this trade more of a win for them? The answer is probably going to depend on chemistry. Real life isn't like NBA 2K, and putting star players on a team together without paying attention to chemistry can be a recipe for disaster, just as much as it's a recipe for success. It's hard to say how things will pan out for the Nets when it comes to this trade, but the risks are there. Putting Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant on the same team is already an experimental move, and we don't know how it will pan out. Putting Harden on the roster, fresh off the drama from Houston, is only adding fuel to the possible fire. And it wouldn't take something crazy to spark that fire. We've already seen Irving miss 7 games this season after disappearing from public view to handle personal matters. Irving has returned, but that still rubbed many people the wrong way due to the large contract the Nets are paying him and his inability to show up consistently in the early season. That situation was weird enough on its own, but throw in something like some drama over Harden not passing the ball enough to Durant and Irving, and you might find yourself with a team that will perform far under its full potential because it just can't make things work on the roster front. But on the other hand, the Nets have more superstar players than any other team in the Eastern Conference. And even if we haven't seen how those superstars will gel together, they're still the team to beat for every other team in the East. And if you look at it from that perspective, you can give the Nets a good grade on this trade, knowing that becoming the team to beat was their main intention through their moves over the past couple of years, and most recently with this trade.